Her mission is to give children a voice through writing and art. World-renowned author Elizabeth Hoadley is visiting elementary schools in Flushing this week doing just that. And today, Elizabeth is here to focus in on her work and other goals for children around the world. Also joining us in the studio, Shayna Harris, Chief Operating Officer from Sunshine Workshop, a resource that Elizabeth created for children using art and the written word to encourage hope. Let's start with your background. It's something in your past that made this a passion for you.
Actually, it was less of a passion than it was a need.
Okay.
When I was very, very young, I didn't speak very well. I spoke fine until I was around five, and then I stopped speaking in a way that was easy. I stuttered very, very badly, and for the most part, I wasn't able to speak at all unless I was speaking to friends and family. At which point I was fine, but the minute I spoke to anyone outside of that, I really could not speak. And so my school tried to get me to go to a speech therapist, and that didn't work because I wouldn't speak. So my mother and I communicated often through a book of poetry. I would leave it on the table, and I would write what was in my heart in the book, and she would answer in a poem back. And through that and through my taking art lessons, I literally was able to create a voice when I had no voice. And that is my message to the children here in Michigan. Even though they potentially can speak, sometimes for many, many reasons, you can't speak up to potentially your family, your mom, your dad, your friends. You feel shy, you feel alone. What can you do to find a voice, even if you have a voice, if no one hears you?
All right, you brought some of your books with you. What are your topics? They're sometimes unique topics.
Well, Elizabeth speaks on a great deal of topics: homelessness, parental incarceration. I think healthy hugs and sweet snuggles. The reconstruction efforts in Aquila and the Three Graces. Vivace, about three charming fish with different personality traits.
Well, here's a good example
if
you don't mind.
That's a really good example.
All right, I'm holding some of your books right here. And the workshop that you're involved in, tell us about this resource.
Okay, well, that's exactly it. I essentially made sure that Elizabeth is enabled to appear in places like Flushing or wherever the need is great, so that these materials that I believe in so much, because I've known her my whole life, get out there, and they are making a remarkable impression. From Dr. Elmadi Said and Dr. Disman's office to Casey Cronin at the Flushing Community School District, they are really making remarkable impression, and I'm just so happy for her.
And we're seeing some of your appearance today. Your daughter writes as well.
She actually illustrates. So she will help me to write in that. She will change if she doesn't like what she sees. But she's actually been the one who's illustrated, because this is how I teach her lessons that I would like her to know. So her first book was illustrated at 2, and this was about just how to take care of yourself. And at 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And this book here, it's called Vivace, and it encourages her to be able to choose the right friends and to follow dreams and goals. So these are actually conversations between mommy and daughter, because sometimes I still do not convey everything I would like to verbally as well as I would like, so I write it in a book and she illustrates it. And I know she takes home the messages on how to be a better person.
Well, you've certainly found your voice, whether it's verbal or in print. So thank you both for coming in. If you'd like more information about Elizabeth Hoadley's books and work, you can log on to our website, abc12.com, click on the See It on TV tab.